अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू इन दिस सोशल क्लास। एज वी आर लर्निंग अवर 18th लेसन गवर्निंग अवर सेल्फ, आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट एज यू नो दैट अवर इंडिया इज एन इंडिपेंडेंट कंट्री एंड अवर इंडिया इज एन्जॉइंग अ सर्टन राइट्स। एज इंडियंस वी आर एन्जॉइंग अ सर्टन राइट्स एंड वी आर परफॉर्मिंग सर्टन ड्यूटीज एंड वी हैव टू ओबे दैट सर्टन लॉस। So government, as you know that government and then as you know about the India become independent and the leaders sat down to create rules to govern the country, that document is known as the Constitution of India. And as you know that now India is having a 28 states and 8 union territories, and states, each state has its own government, that is called state government, and which is responsible for maintaining law and order within the state itself. And as all, there is also one overall government for the entire country, that is known as the central government, which make laws for the whole country and also govern and make sure that it should be followed. And union territory is directly governed by the central government. We have seen that, and we have seen here each level of the government, that government is divided into three branches, that is legislature, executive and judiciary. And we have seen that legislature means makes the laws for the country, executive law put the laws into force, judiciary protect that laws, settle the disputes. Okay, these are the judiciary. And we have seen here making laws about legislature, we see in the central government. See, the parliament is the lawmaking body of the central government, and the parliament has two houses like Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. So the member of the Lok Sabha, which are directly elected by the people through elections, and the members of Rajya Sabha, which are indirectly elected. So now we will see about the Lok Sabha, Lok Sabha, Lok Sabha. See, Lok Sabha is directly elected by the people, and it is also called the House of the People. And another name of Lok Sabha is Lower House. So, as per according to the constitution, the maximum number of members in the house is 552, out of which 530 members are to represent the states, and 20 members are represent the from the union territories, and 2 members are to be nominated by the president from the Anglo-Indian communities. Okay, and any Indian citizens who is 25 years old is eligible for contest of election in the Lok Sabha, and if elected by the people, so the citizens will become a member of parliament or MP. Okay, so these members of parliament elect the speaker of the Lok Sabha, who guides the proceedings during the session, and or he or she is assisted by the deputy speaker also, and also elected by the members. And the Lok Sabha has a 5 years of term, after which the fresh elections will be held every after 5 years. Okay, so now we will see about the Rajya Sabha. See, the Rajya Sabha are the Central Council of States, and it is also called Upper House. And the Lok Sabha members are elected by the members of the Rajya Sabha members are elected by the members of the state legislative assemblies, so 12 members are nominated by the President of India, and the nominated members usually known as the intellectuals from the fields of arts, and they are from art, literature, science, social, and also for sports person. And the Vice President of India is the Chairman of Rajya Sabha. The Vice President of India is the Chairman of Rajya Sabha. So students, we will stop here. I hope you have understood this, and read the lesson once. Thank you.